How many of us are left? Too many of us have folded our arms. Too many of us have slept. Daily, terminator dreams rise like a tsunami, stretching longer than the river Nile. Our starving children watch and cry. They ask their soon-to-die mothers, why? We say, the confused say, black is crust, but daily we fuel their confusion. Who then is confused? On black soil, black bodies fall as black bullets thrust. So I ask, how many more souls must be lost?
Though some people are merely existing instead of living, but the life is full of pain, tears, and sorrow, and they wish they don't get to see tomorrow. Reason being, they are victims of domestic violence, and they wonder, what is life's essence? Because the life is full of tears instead of laughter, pain instead of pleasure, sorrow instead of joy, fear instead of hope, and a bruised and battered body instead of a healthy one.
There are voiceless voices aching inside, seeking mad repairs to save the heart from the hurts they feel. Like those women who bear children despite the punches that slice the skin down to the artery. I read the stories of violence tattooed on the faces of those people. I saw helplessness, and sometimes it came clearer when the dark night cuts in the tears of those women. So let's drop the chorus of my mother is free, my sister is free, cause not a victim yet, needs protection as the victim girl. I know we all have a lot of airs and our arms to braid, but violence is the toughest assassin to jail. Let's tear up the pages paging punishment for our women. Let's stop this heartbeat of violence.
As you dip yourself inside it, does your soul rise from the shackles yearning to be free? Do you hear the lullaby of your demons and tormented screams? Does the smell of putrid human flesh ignite your passion? Do her sobs chant the forward march of your cause? Do you see true beauty only in her mutilation? Could the sound of breaking bones to you be heaven's applause? Is the loving wine from the cup of her heart to you distasteful? Would you rather reach for her very soul and take that which makes her feel alive? Do her smiles and laughter irritate you? Would you have it be rivers of withered hopes flow from her eyes? Look through the lens, I beg. Do you see the shattered homes and hearts? Hearts that know joy no more. Do you see dreams fade as the years pass? Ironical, she's being killed daily by the one she would die for. Stop the violence, he said. Appreciate the one who won't tell every single thought in your head.
Pull the trigger that took my life but took your soul in turn. Now that I'm gone, does it make you a better person? You came home drunk, met me happy, looked me in the eye, but my excitement filled you with spite. Dragged me down the stairs, ripped my fragile strands of hair off my scalp. The look on my face, now that's so fair. My head continuously bouncing off the descending steps like a b-ball in the hand of Larry Bird. Like an attractive step, repeated the process over and over again. Cause stupid me was ready to stick with you over and over again. Till my life refused to stay one last time. And in protest, he said goodbye the final time. Now that I'm dead, with no more human backs for you to punch without reason. So tell me, does it make you a better person?
That woman who just crossed the street, she has nothing to eat, no shoes on her feet. You just yelled an insult without thinking anything about it, not even caring why she got so distracted, not knowing that she was raped, she has nowhere to stay. She lives day to day, not knowing if tomorrow will be okay, because she was just diagnosed with HIV/AIDS. And with each word that you say, she's one step further away from holding on to life. So now she contemplates putting an end to her strife. This happens to thousands who go unnoticed and die right before our own very eyes. So please put that justice into this unjust practice and stop the violence.